that number one, she has no power to preside over the meeting, and that I have asked her to step aside. She refused, and I ordered her to leave the meeting. Number two, I have said that the eviction of several members of the Legislative Council is an unlawful eviction of members of the Legislative Council. I order that they be allowed to return to room one to continue with the meeting. And I've said that for the record. I think it is very important for me to set it officially so it is recorded in the official record of the meeting. Any questions?
其實他們是完全沒有吸取上面逃犯條例的教訓，他們認為有些事情他們不喜歡見到，所以他們就硬來去打破過去的傳統議事規則，就硬來。其實跟上次逃犯條例是完全一模一樣的，我相信市民大家都會明白為什麼他們這樣做，為什麼他們要這麼深究，之後我民主派的同事是會在這方面補充。有沒有其他問題？It's shocking. It's absolutely shocking. After, you know, not just the past 7 months of holding this view, this is actually the view held by the Secretariat and the Legal Advisor for the longest time, that we interpret the rules of procedure and the House rules in this manner. And today we see a 180 degree turn on the part of the Legal Advisor. Frankly, as a lawyer, I can't see why that is possible, but you know, there are lawyers who stand firm on legal principles, and I believe that the opinion of Philip Deitz and Johannes Chan, to correct legal principles and interpretation of rules of procedure. And I don't understand how the legal advisor could change her stance like that.
What's your own plan today? And are you going to go back to the meeting? What's
your that is not a proper meeting. What is happening in there right now is an illegitimate exercise of the power to chair and preside over meetings. It is wrong, it is illegitimate, it is in breach of the rules of procedure. Okay, thank you.
但好可惜，我哋見到又其實如果大家有留意嘅話，其實由點零鐘當時一房係冇會議進行嘅，我哋已經見到保安人員有動作，而當時主持會議係冇人主持會議，而呢一啲嘅我哋叫 order 命令係由邊個落嘅咧？而且當郭榮鏗在3:05正式宣布要趕李慧瓊出去的時候，完全是沒有保安採取過任何的行動。大家不要忘記今早上的會議清清楚楚跟足程序，由主持會議的郭榮鏗議員聽完這麼多位議員充分講述關於那幾份法律意見的情況， 而我哋亦都清清楚楚聽到郭榮鏗議員話下晝嘅會係會繼續進行選舉正副主席嘅事宜，而建制派都等唔切啦，就要用呢一個方式，用一個法律外間嘅法律顧問愛嚟佔住我哋自己秘書處嘅法律顧問嘅底，再俾李慧瓊操刀。大家睇到嗰個利益衝突、角色衝突，甚至係奪權、越權嘅情況，完全係徹底破壞立法會嘅情況。最大嘅問題咩啫？就係建制派等唔切啫嘛，咁就已經要做呢啲事情啦。李慧瓊本來當然我哋唔係叫佢退選，但係喺我哋嗰一份嘅法律意見充分提供咗兩個可能俾佢考慮。第一，考慮退選，唔好忘記第一次講話退選嘅時候，李慧瓊話如果民主派嘅人退選，佢都會考慮嘅嚇。是他先作呼籲的，大家不要忘記啊！我今天特登再查過的，之後就是讓我們選舉主席那個會議盡快可以處理現在相關的一些議程，包括是一些動議和有約束力的議案，跟住我們就可以正式進入去選舉主席、副主席的情況，但是都等不切了。而且今天既然下午的會李慧瓊是無權做，他亦都是無權趕一眾的民主派議員出去，很可惜我們不單止見到保安只是執行李慧瓊的決定或者指示，甚至我們見到有建制派的議員動粗，令到我不知道有沒有令到我們的民主派議員受傷。幾時輪到佢啊？喺呢個情況之下，我哋覺得根本無論係秘書處、無論係保安、無論建制派呢一個咁樣嘅串通，徹徹底底重複翻，只不過係一年之前送中條例時候嘅情況。不過今次變本加厲，你如果有留意到保安全部戴曬嗰啲行動手套嘅。以往冇的扎曬行馬，不停地俾李慧瓊信息，你點點，跟住再配合秘書安排整個嘅行動，根本都係視民主派議員，我唔知道完全冇尊敬過，或者完全係冇尊重過，甚至可以話係敵人，政見唔同冇緊要，但係。亦都不需要用這樣的權去行使，或者甚至用這樣的力是行使下去跟他政見不同的人身上，我覺得完全是超越了所需要的一些武力或者甚至是力量。而我們仍然在房間裏面有我們的戰友，我們不是留下他，我絕對不，我很希望大家要明白到我們現在面對著的是什麼的環境。當然法律顧問今天有說了幾點新的原則，大家都可能在混亂之中可能都聽到少少，但是詳細的情況當然我們要考慮清楚，我們亦都會將相關的可能阿允入了醫院，或者甚至有同事被保安以外的議員傷害的話，這些我們一定會作出跟進。我現在請其他的同事去先講一講他們的看法，然後接著我再做補充。
我有幾點分析和觀察，第一就是有強權就沒有公理，仲慘在咧，唔係冇公理嘅實質，而係冇公理嘅程序嘅，即係連個程序達至公道咧，即係我哋嘅法律顧問、秘書處同埋咧係建制派，包括係李慧瓊， 議員咧都唔顧啦，已經。咁當然啦，如果你講翻一年前，大家都幾熟悉嘅，當時我端端點解會開會嘅時候都冇秘書處嚟嘅咧？咁啊，即係已經知道咧，只要誰控制秘書處，誰控制警衛、保安。咁即係等於香港，誰控制解放軍，誰控制警隊？咁於是咪有佢講冇你講咯，包括你記者噴你咪噴你咯。即係而家情況就係咁啊。第二點觀察咧就係、我咁諗啊，好啊，你當係假假地做戲都好，你係咪至少你嘅法律顧問嘅意見你都全面披露啊？佢確認喎，秘書處冇披露喎。咁你冇披露，咁即係連個程序公義都冇。咁即係我假設啦，所有議員都冇嘅，除非佢打龍通啦。咁即係換句話講，李慧瓊都冇。咁你又從何可以得出幾份嘅意見書裏面嘅結論呢？就話你自己有權開會呢？咁仲有，你退一萬步，佢都未開會，都未話聲稱佢開會，竟然點幾鐘呢就有人根據好似佢聲稱係開會會講嘅嘢，然後就早咗成個鐘頭呢就已經守住個台喎，就唔係郭榮亨可以上去主持，而係就係呢佢可以主持。咁啊，最尾一點呢就係、你睇到呢整個過程裏面呢，其實我們的秘書處根本呢就已經不是政治中立，即我講得白一點，我今天呢看了好像是朱凱廸，他就 有篇文的，他可能講回他那些演辭啦，這兩樣他就數出他很多的秘書處不公道的地方，他認為呢如果這樣不公道的秘書處呢，即係而家你區議會都係咁噶啦，啲秘書處，即係講得白啲咧，就係其實就係中聯辦、港澳辦一發功，全面管治，咁啊管埋建制派議員，再管埋立法，管埋香港政特區政府，就管埋立法會秘書處同埋啲保安，管曬啦，全面管治。最尾一句。如果發生咁嘅話咧，我相信咧，可能將來發展到咧，無論邊個當選議員啊，而家將來，只要啲警察出面入嚟，有人話一聲，唔知道特區政府係邊個啦，或者有個 QC 有個 SC 話唔係喎，呢、這個應該被 DQ 喎，咁個警察就嚟捉咗佢走啦。先咧，可能咧個會議廳咧就保安捉佢出去先。然後呢捉佢出門口，跟住警察拉佢。即係而家呢成個發展呢，香港人呢要睇清楚，係要抵抗，係要反抗。因為呢我哋從前所諗嘅，喂都有啲有文有路，有個程序公義，冇啦。佢有槍，佢有保安，佢根本當你議員呢係冇嘢。無論如何，我呢個觀察呢，我希望不會進一步成真，不過我是很擔心。
今天下午立法會的親北京建制派保皇黨追隨，以及我們的立法會秘書處，加上我們的所謂法律顧問，更加要加上立法會的保安，他們一眾的行為你看到是有個劇情的，不單止是精心設計，隨時是已經經過彩排，是一點十五分已經彈出來、赤裸裸，他完全現在連扮嘢都費事，他是告訴你聽我要這樣做就這樣做，就很明顯是北京的 行一種指令嚟嘅。我哋飛機師好中意話佢哋嚇受到激活嚇、英文叫 invigorated 啊，即刻彈起七情上面。而家佢哋嘅態度就係要將香港嘅立法會喺九月立法會選舉之前係將你徹底顛覆。佢哋話點就點，係不顧一切。不惜任何代價的一種做法嚟嘅。They are interpreting this very famous line: power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. We witnessed what happened this afternoon. They claim every single bit of power, as long as it fits with their plan, their scheme, they can just go ahead.And we need to tell Hong Kongers, we are putting up a fight. We're not taking anything just lying down, but we are being outnumbered. They can beat us by sheer number. So ladies and gentlemen, all Hong Kongers, please support the Democrats. We will fight on. Okay.
就係奪權。咩叫奪權呢？本來唔應該有嘅權，然之後佢用某啲嘅方法去攞到個權，呢個就係奪權。一個禮拜之前，李慧瓊有冇主持呢個會議嘅呢種嘅權力呢？大家都知道，當時我哋冇人會認為佢有嘅。一個禮拜之後，今日點解可以有？通過一啲所謂法律嘅方法，而法律方法頭先陶謹申講咗，如果你真係要做嘅話，起碼立法會裏頭嘅法律顧問應該有一個報告再交出嚟，你先可以話咧呢個法律啊，嗰個意見咧係有一定嘅喺議會裏頭嘅地位。但係而家隨隨便便喺外邊嗰度拎份報告就可以話咧。有一個法律的建議了，這個我覺得是沒可能可以成立，然後再用的方法就是用保安帶路來到護送李慧瓊上對主席台。這個做法是什麼呢？就是我們經常見到的各種的奪權的做法，它依賴的是什麼？就是保安而不是法律，不是道理。今次整個過程裏頭，不是講法律，不是講道理，亦都不是講政治上的協商，而是用一種權力的方法來到去奪取權力。我們今後如果繼續是這樣的話，將會是立法會非常之黑暗的日子。我希望大家看清楚現在我們面對的問題，我哋一定咧係要堅持，我哋令到議會嘅規矩能夠可以重新係喺樹立翻起上。
嗱，我哋俾掌聲阿蕭先啊！
多謝多謝。其實今日係立法會其中一個好黑暗嘅日子，因為好清楚咧。李慧瓊是主權的，其實我們法律顧問之前都講得很清楚，過去半年來大家都尊重這個議事規則，但是突然間一個外聘的大律師一個意見就可以將我們的議事規則完全扭曲，然後李慧瓊就咁就話佢自己有權，大家好清楚，佢係有利益衝突。佢作為一個未退任嘅主席，而家正係要選舉新主席，而佢喺選舉嘅期間已經執行主席整個嘅任務嘅時候咧，其實呢個係完全違反我哋議事規則，議事規則亦都係因此咧要避免呢種。衝突咧就話我哋嘅第一次會議一定要選舉主席，而直至選舉到新任主席為止嘅。 所以今次呢一個係奪權，今次呢個係完全係奪取所有我哋議事規則俾佢嘅權力。佢哋背後當然就係共產黨。今日好清楚，成件事佢喺警察嚟到監控，我見到可能遲啲佢會向司法、向教育、向傳媒埋手。香港人，大家一定要抗爭到底。
I can't see the end of it. And they shouldn't think that this is the end. This is just the beginning. And it shows clearly to all people of Hong Kong that how the Secretariat, including our securities, and together with the legal advisor, take sides so biased and to support what have already decided by the pro-establishment camp. We cannot see impartiality, we can only see bias, including how they exercise or how they execute the instructions of Mr. Dennis Kwok, Mr. Honorable Mr. Dennis Kwok. You can remember in the morning when he's dealing with the election of the chairman and the vice chairman of the House Committee, he exercised his power rights according to our House as well as the rules. And as a floor, he decided that in order to facilitate the election, he would continue to be the presiding chairman to hold the meeting in the afternoon. And at the same time, Mr. Starry Lee has no power and absolute ultraviolet to call a meeting and not discussing the election of the House Committee, the chairman and the vice chairman of the House Committee. And it is very clearly stated in our legal opinion. And I would like to emphasize that there is still a secret part of the legal opinion that we can't assess. But the chairman has used our money to seek this legal advice. We disclose our legal advice as soon as opportunity, and the people of the public, people of Hong Kong, can thoroughly study it and to analyze it or even to disagree with it. However, until today, this moment, we still haven't received any indication or answer from the chairman telling us what kind of legal advice has he sought. And we have no idea what kind of issues and why he did not seek our approval or consent before he made instructions to the instructing solicitor. So this is absolutely unacceptable, and it's hiding something very important from us as well as Hong Kong.
他有没有
Let me first answer your question in English first. This is not the end. This is not the end of our fight. It will only be the end if the people of Hong Kong choose to end the fight. And I believe the people of Hong Kong will not choose to end the fight like this. That's the first thing. We will do our part inside the legislature. But we need people of Hong Kong to do whatever they can to win this fight. Within the House Committee, don't forget, Dennis Kwok will continue to host the legitimate meeting that is about the election of the chairperson for the House Committee. However, I would not be very surprised if the pro-establishment people who are still inside this illegal meeting going on right now, that they are going to probably say that we do not need to elect a new chairman anymore because the previous chair can continue for the rest of the term. That may happen. That may happen. And if that happens, I think Hong Kong people will see again how the pro-establishment, pro-Beijing camp, and also our so-called legal advisor are going to be bending the rules again and again and again to revoke whatever they have said before as legitimate, and now they claim something else to be legitimate purely for their own convenience. 即係我頭先講嘅咧，就係呢個唔會係我哋最後嘅抗爭嘅最後，只有香港人決定呢個抗爭係去到邊一度。我哋喺議會入邊會盡我哋嘅做我哋嘅應該嘅嘢，但係大家唔好唔記得，國榮亨咧仲要係再繼續主持呢一個嘅選舉主席喺呢一個內會嘅會議，但係咧隨時而家喺度。 開緊會嗰班，開緊呢個非法會議嘅李慧瓊同埋嗰班保皇黨就會話，連主席都唔使再選啦，反正呢一個所謂主席就繼續做落去就算啦。呢個可能會發生喎，到時大家就更加赤裸裸咁睇到呢班嘅保皇黨，同埋立法會嘅秘書處同埋嗰個叫做所謂法律顧問。
但其實咧，我今日覺得佢講啲嘢冇一句係法律嘅，全部係政治。根本係一個政治顧問，佢哋係幾個？咁因為今日咧，我哋仲有另外一個政府嘅記者會啦，咁所以咧，今日泛民嘅回應咧，我哋就會直播到呢度咁多嘅。咁歡迎各位嘅觀眾咧，可以之後再睇翻我哋文字報道。 咁就多謝曬支持。